Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay, a stout-eyed man. Why am I playing all this old music stuff? Bolder and bolder. Just because, just to bring attention to certain words, you know, bold and strong, stout. I'll just put a stop to this. Brilliant stuff, isn't it? Right, that was a bit of Nelson Eddy, stout-eyed men. Now, I'm going to kind of go on a meandering course here, so bear with me. I'll try to be as quick as I can and get the beer open and go for it and everything else. If I mention stout, the first thing you think of is black with a little white top, kind of Guinnesses, Mackeson, Murphy's, and some of the Imperial Russian stouts and things like that that usually don't have any head at all and everything. But you kind of think of those sort of beers. Now, the term stout is an old term. It's still kind of just drifting around today. You hear certain things like a stout-eyed fellow and a stout-eyed man and that, you know. And as the song goes, give me some men, some stout-eyed men and that, you know. Go away, cat. Go on. So I've got the cat meowing at me. Stout-eyed men. He's put me off now. Now, we've got... What I kind of thought was an oxymoron. But if we're going to talk about oxymoria, I think you've got to kind of go into things like India Parallel, Black IPA, Black Pal Ale. It's kind of Parallel's become a term, and Black IPA has then become a term if you've got a dark version of that. American India Parallel, American IPA. Well, America didn't have kind of the kind of empire thing to have an IPA. So again, a kind of oxymoron. So you'd think that white stout is an oxymoron. Whereas I think you have to try it first in order to actually go, ah, now I get it. Because I've luckily got two of these down, and I already had one of them, and it was glorious. Now, so I can't really act surprised when I drink it. I can't kind of go, oh, like that, because, well, I will, because it's, you know, it's, I'm really looking forward to it. But I've already tasted it, you know, and it is big. It's really big. I love the fact that they've got it in a 500ml bottle, because that kind of proves a point that it's stout. It's stout, strong, big, powerful, in all sorts of different ways. And not just in the kind of American IPA way of having hefty hops. This has got hefty hops as well as having like a hefty, just a minute, as well as having, it's got hefty hops as well as having a hefty malt fix, but on lighter kind of paler malts, but good quality stuff. Right, I'll quickly show you around the bottle. I don't want to tip it around too much. Beautiful little kind of subtle labelling. It says serve at 10. I might just be a tad over that because I've been preparing a few bits and pieces. But this is a resurrection of an old style. So it's kind of a new genre, and it's not a new genre. It's kind of a resurrection. It's an erection section resurrection. That's what it is. There's the cap there. Very plain crown. But that's okay. It's dignified. Now, I'm kind of going, I'm going to be treating some of you guys out there, because I'm getting more and more people saying, stick an head on the beer's till. So, I'm going to pour it round the way I usually do, and I'm going to hopefully stick an head right on the lastminute.com. And because the brewers, as you know, as a few people have said, the brewers brew certain ingredients in order to add the head. You know, things like wheat have got bigger proteins and stretchier proteins, and they had a lovely big head on it. So I'm gonna see if I can put a nice creamy head on without kind of sticking any of the sediment in, because it is a bottle conditioned beer. Now, that's what we got. That is our stout. Let me just get that out of the way, and I'm gonna get something white. Whatever got that is white, however not. That will do. A little envelope there. And that is the colour that, let me see. That's the colour I'm getting, no. Yeah, it's a kind of golden colour, a lovely sunshine in the glass colour. Now, note these bubbles. Have a note of these bubbles here, right? The way that they slowly climb through that glass. The liquid that denotes a core, denotes a bigger, heftier mouthfeel straight away. You got that is holding on to its own head, so there's stretchy, lovely proteins in there. You got all sorts of lovely, kind of fruity American hops in there. A slight biscuity smell, but the main aromas are big, hefty, big, kind of wet leaf, kind of whole leaf hops that are fruity, big fruity hops. I'm going in. And maybe sometime. Woo! Quite a mouthfeel. A mouthful, I should say, and quite a mouthfeel as well. But it's not kind of, it's not kind of gluey and kind of a, you know, that kind of, that thing you get with some of the crass beers that when you got the E405 added and things like that, you get glueiness. This is thick because it's got loads of malt in there. Loads of hops to go with it, and they balance out beautifully. That is absolutely glorious. God, that is superb. Now, the reason that I like that it's in a 500 bottle is because if you're not getting the concept, I didn't grasp the concept at first. You know, when people like Ellie was kind of from the Durham Brewery, when she was kind of mentioning a white stout, I'm like, yeah. And it sounded, forgive me for saying this, you know, it sounded like a bit of a gimmick. Now, you try it and you realise it ain't a gimmick. It's an actual bona fide kind of a bona fide genre, a bona fide style. That really needs to be woken up again. It is a little bit similar to American IPAs, but instead of just a hop, it's a hop and a malt, and it's banging together. It's glorious. It's quite a big ABV. You're getting peaches. You're getting kind of a. You're getting a little bit of almost like a muscovado sugar there as well. Peaches, you're getting apricots, you're getting lychees, my missus calls them, you're getting lychees, you're getting Oh, it's all sorts of stuff there. What else? A big fruit pot is in there. But you've also got the crust of a freshly baked white loaf of bread. That's so superb. Go out and buy that and try that. That is absolutely glorious. That is White Stout from the Durham Brewery. And that is something else. And it's a pale stout. White stout. Fantastic, isn't it? Cheers, chin chin. Burp. Bottoms up.